Then De Goey sealed it, this time with a handball to a tearaway Jaidyn Stephenson to finish a tremendous contest, aided upfield by a crucial mark by the big American Mason Cox. For the Lions, it was another heartbreaking case of close, but no cigar. But Collingwood, perhaps, have a bigger problem. A shudder had gone through the Magpies in the third quarter as Scott Pendlebury went off, taking his boot off and going straight down the race. He was back quickly, then off again, clearly impeded by an ankle problem. The results of the inevitable scans will surely be a determining factor in Collingwood's year. Tap out, Stephen Martin and Brody Grundy fought a fierce battle in the ruck. Photo, AAPTHE first quarter was a rotten spectacle, with both sides turning the ball over, especially inside their own forward half. Heavy dew in Brisbane is often used as an excuse in these twilight games, but most of the clangers were being made by foot, and both sides wasted opportunities to score. Players who were clean stood out, none more so than Pendlebury, who looks back to his brilliant best after a thumb injury curtailed his season in 2017. He strolled in for the Magpies first after 11 minutes. He's no quicker than he ever was, but who needs speed when you still play the game like you're hypnotizing chickens? Minutes later he was involved again in a chain that ended with Chris Mayne, and at the beginning of the second quarter he released Adam Treloar with a looping handball out of traffic. The Magpies looked to be bursting clear, Jordan De Goey opening up a 20-point lead from Alou Kajer. From there, the second quarter turned into a frenzied shootout. The Lions kicked the next four goals, Lewis Taylor briefly pinching the lead for the home side with his first. Zorko didn't have a hard tag and was damaging, so too Captain Dane Beams, the pair accumulating 37 touches for the half. Clawed back, Brisbane's Darcy Gardiner tackles Jaidyn Stephenson of Collingwood. Photo, AAP Collingwood steadied, though, and hit back with Josh Thomas continuing an excellent run of form with three goals in 10 minutes, Darcy Moore also getting involved in his return with a fast lead and excellent conversion from the boundary line. Then the Lions replied again, Charlie Cameron and Taylor making it a three-point game. It gave the Lions the points for the quarter with 7-6, and asked some questions of both coaches. Nathan Buckley, praised for his remodeled defense this year, has been bitten by his reluctance to lock down on players. But Chris Fagan had problems, too, with Pies playmaker Sidebottom and Pendlebury also off the chain. Neither blinked. Sidebottom continued to have a picnic for the Pies. Charlie Cameron's influence grew for the Lions, threading the needle twice with passes to Taylor, for his third goal, and Zorko, who continued to find, and be given space. Travis Varka gave Collingwood space, Taylor's speed netted him a fourth. By this point, Pendlebury was off, and Taylor was involved again and gifting a goal by hand to Bailey. Stephenson kept the Magpies 8 points clear at the last change, and he was crucial in the final exchange to seal the deal. Brisbane Lions 3.0 10.0 14.2 18.6 114, Collingwood 4.2 10.3 15.4 19.7 121 goals. Brisbane Lions, Taylor 4, Zorko 3, Robinson, McStay, Beams, McInerney, McCluggage, Barry Cameron, Bailey. Collingwood, De Goey 5, Thomas 3, Pendlebury, Mayne, Howe, Treloar, Moore, Phillips, Cox, Varka, Stephenson, Hoskin, Elliott. Best, Brisbane Lions, Taylor, Beams, Zorko, Andrews, Bailey, Martin. Collingwood, Sidebottom, De Goey, Pendlebury, Thomas, Treloar, Varka. Injuries, Collingwood, Pendlebury, ankle. Brisbane, nil. Umpires, Rosebery, Wett and Williamson. Prow, 21,850 at the Gabba. BOTESD Zorko, Brisbane, 9D Beams, Brisbane, 8S Sidebottom, Collingwood, 7J De Goey, Collingwood, 7L Taylor, Brisbane, 7 Match Report, Collingwood, Brisbane Lions.